Dear students, today I'll be teaching you some problems in the module 3. We'll learn some problems on viewport and polygon clipping. Sutherland and Hodgman polygon clipping algorithm, Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm. In the previous class, I was talking about how to convert from one coordinate system to another coordinate system. We will see one example on this, that is the window parameters to the viewport parameters. Say suppose we have been given the values of the window and also the viewport. We have the values here, the window values of the clipping window of the window and the viewport. This is the reference what I am taking. So I am going to take a point called as XWYW and I am going to map that onto a viewport at a point called as XV and YV. So we have seen this ratio. If the point has to be neatly mapped, this ratio has to be satisfied. So by looking at this ratio, I can find out what is the value of XV, because I know the value of the viewport min maximum, window minimum and maximum. Because I know these four parameters, I can find the value of the XV from the first formula. I also know the XW value, so it won't be difficult for me to find out what is the value of XV. So here I have got the value of XV as 35. So XW, what we had, that was equal to 30. But now the XV, it has been mapped as 35. Similarly, we can find the value of YV from the second formula. In the second formula, we know the value of the YV minimum, YV maximum, YW minimum and the YW max. We also know the value of YW. So previously the YW value was equal to 80 and now it has been mapped to 60. So from this example, we can learn that how we can map from the window to the viewport, how actually it works, how the ratio works. Here you can see we had the scaling formula. The scaling formula for the X was the X window's minimum and maximum for the viewport and the window. SY was the minimum and the maximum for the window of the window as well as the viewport. So if you consider the SX and the SY value, for the given value, we are getting the SX value is equal to 0.5 and SY is equal to 0.5. which means that the scaling has happened, which is equal to 0.5. The point X and Y, or we have XW and YW, they have been scaled up by a factor of 0.5. SY is also a factor of 0.5. That means SX and SY, both of them have been increased by a 0.5 factor. We can find what is the translation of the point. So we can see that the translation of the point, it depends upon the parameters in the window and the viewport, which is given by the maximum and the minimum value on the X direction and on the Y direction. So the translation, when we substitute the given values, you can see that the translation is happening in 20 units on the X direction and 20 units on the Y direction. We also have the final formula XV, which is equal to SX and XW plus TX. So you can cross verify that this will also give you the proper result, because we have computed SX and SY also by using the window parameters. TX and TY are also calculated by using the window parameters. So finally, I am going to get my point XV and YV as 35 and 60, which was previously on the window, it was equal to 30 and 80. So this is an example for how we can go for normalization and viewport transformations. In the normalization and viewport transformations, a point on a window is been mapped to a point on a viewport. Coming to the next problem, that is the Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping algorithm. So polygon clipping algorithm, I told you there are many types. For us, which is of interest is only of one type, that is the Sutherland-Hodgman clipping algorithm. How does this work? So basically, it requires clipping on all the window edges, that is the window borders. The polygon clipping here is performed by processing the boundary of the polygon against each edge of the clipping window. That means the clipping window will be having the left window, the right window, the top window, and the bottom window. So the polygon clipping is going to happen with respect to each of these edges. First of all, entire polygon is clipped against one edge. Then whatever the remaining polygon is there, that is considered as the input for the second stage. That means for the second edge. Similarly, it is done for all the four edges. What are the conditions we have to look into when we are solving a problem by using the Sutherland-Hodgman clipping algorithm? So the first condition is, suppose the first vertex of a line is outside the window and the second vertex is inside the window. Then we have to add the second vertex to the output list. So we have to remember these conditions. The first vertex, if it is outside, the second vertex is inside. That means outside to inside. When I say outside and inside, that means it is present inside the clipping window, it is present outside the clipping window. So if we are having a first vertex outside, second vertex inside, then the second vertex is added to the output list. So the point of intersection, what will be there between the first vertex and the second vertex, that will be added to our output. This is an example where we have a line V1, V2. So V1 is the starting point and V2 is the second point. So V1 to V2 when we are going, so this line is from outside to inside. So when it is from outside to inside, what we have to do? We have to add the intersection point V22 and V2 to the output list, and we are going to reject V1 and V22. So this is from outside to inside. Second condition, if both vertices are inside the window boundary, then only the second vertex is added to the output list. If both the vertices are inside, so there is no need to add the first vertex because it will be coming along with other edge. There is no need to worry. We have to remember this condition. It works fine. So the condition 2 is, if both the vertices are inside the window boundary, then only the second vertex has to be taken into the output list. So this is an example. We have V1 as well as V2, both of them are lying within a clipping window. So what we are going to do, we are going to add the second point. If I consider V1 as the first point and V2 as the second point, there is an edge V1 to V2. I am going to consider the second point, that is V2, to my output list. The third condition in the Sutherland-Hodgman algorithm is, if the first vertex is inside and the second is outside the window, then the edge which is intersecting with the window, that is added to the output list. So what we are going to do, we are going to add the edge which is intersecting with the window to the output list. So this is an example here. So we have an edge from V1 to V2. So we are going to add V2 to, that means the intersection point of V1 and V2 to our output list. The point what is there, that will be considered and then it will be added to the output list. So inside to outside, only one point, that is intersection point. Inside to outside, you have to remember this. Inside to outside, one point, that is intersection. So it is, suppose if I am having outside to inside, then we have two points. Fourth condition is, if both the vertices are the outside, are the outside of the window, then nothing is added to the output list. So this need not be considered because both the vertices are outside the window, outside the clipping window. So we don't have to add any vertices to our output list. This is an example. So we have the clipping window, which is a blue color one, and we have the line V1 and V2, which is lying outside. So we don't have to add either V1 or V2. This is rejected trivially. That means completely it has been rejected. I will take an example of an exam paper, that is July 2018, that asked this question. So we can solve this problem and you will understand it clearly. So we have a polygon here and we have a clipping window. We have to explain the Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping algorithm, and we also have to find the final clipped vertices for the following polygon. First, what we have to do, mark all the vertices. So here you can see this polygon, it is having 8 lines. So we are going to mark all the 8 lines here, all the points what are connecting this 8 lines. So the red mark what I have given, all these are nothing but the lines 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. Like this we have all the 8 points over here. These 8 points are nothing but they are connecting here the lines here. First, you have to make the list of all the edges. That means all the lines what we have, that we have to list. So totally I am having 8 lines here. I am going to mark all the 8 lines. The first clip what I am going to apply is the left clip. So you can see here, regarding the direction for a vertex, you can move in either clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. If you start from one point, you have to go in a cyclic manner so that you have to come back to the starting point again. So in this case, I am considering 1 to 2, then from 2 to 3, then from 3 to 4, then from 4 to 5. Like this, I am going to consider in a direction. So first I have made the list of all the edges and now I am going to apply the left clip. So for the left clip, when you consider the window, what is there? For the window, the lines 7 to 8 and 6 to 7, they are intersecting. The meeting point, that means the point where the 6 and 7 is intersecting the window, that is the point 67. And the point which is intersecting the line 7, 8, that is 78. So in this clipping window, now I am going to apply my left clip. When I apply my left clip, I have two lines here, 6 to 7. This line 6 to 7 is going from inside to outside. So we know that whenever we have a line which is going from inside to outside, in my output, I'll have to just mark the intersection point, which will be equal to 67. Then I have one more edge, which is from 7 to 8. So that means the line 7 to 8, it is having intersection point at 78. So when a line is going from outside to inside, the line 6 to 7 was inside to outside, 7 to 8 is from outside to inside. When it is from outside to inside, then I have to mark the intersection point along with the inner point. That means here it will be the 7 and 8 will be reduced to 78 and 8. Obviously, the part which is lying outside the clipping window, that has to be removed. That is why I am going to eliminate that part which is lying outside my left clip. So you can look at the output here. This is the polygon what I am getting after applying the left clip. In the left clip, all the lines which are outside the left border of the clipping window are eliminated completely. Step 2. So here we are having right clip. In the right clip, what we are going to do, we are going to remove all the polygon edges which are outside my right clipping window border. So right clipping window border, anything is there, that will be removed. As usual, I have a list of edges over here. From the previous output, I have taken my input. The previous output will be the present input. So I have a list of all the edges over here, and you can see here, for the right clipping window, I am having two edges again. What are they? 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. So 2 is inside the clipping window, 3 is outside the clipping window. So when we have from inside to outside, we know that we have to consider only the intersection point. So 2 to 3 is reduced to 23. So when I am having a line from 3 to 4, then we know that it is from outside to inside. When it is from outside to inside, we have to consider the intersection point and the inner point. That means the 3 and 4 will be reduced to 34 and 4. There won't be any changes to any other edges because I am talking only about the right clipping window. So once I have my right clipping window, I am going to eliminate all the line, all the picture which is outside my right clipping window. At end of my right clip, I am going to get my output as shown in this figure. So in this figure you can see that now we have 23 and 34, that is the intersection point, 78 and 67, which was the intersection point for the left window. So the left window is there, and then we have the right window. This is the output of my right clip. Now we will go for top clip. That means whatever is outside my clipping window, above my clipping window, that I am going to remove. So the two edges which are coming into picture in this case is 1, 2 and 8, 1. So we can observe that 1, 2 is from outside to inside. When we have from outside to inside, we have to go for the intersection point and the inner point. So we will have 1 and 2 reduced to 12 and 2. Then I have one more edge, that is from 8 to 1. This 8 to 1 is from inside to outside. When we are moving from inside to outside, then what is going to happen? We are going to get the inner point and the point of intersection. That means 8, 1 is reduced to 8, 18. This is happening in my top clip. The edges which are affected in my top clip, they are 1, 2 and 8, 1. So we have two edges affecting, and we are having the output as for 1, 2 it is 12 and 2, for 8, 1 it is 8 and 18. Next one, we take the output of the step 2 and give that as input for my step 3. So when you apply the top clip, you can see that now the intersection points 18 and 12, they are retained. They are retained, and you are going to get the output as what has been shown over here. The table, it has been repeated. So we just have the whatever the output we had, 1, 2, it has been now just reduced to 12, 2. 8, 1 has been reduced to 8, 1, 8. So this is the output what we are getting. The last one is the bottom clip. I am going to remove all the edges which are below the clipping window. So the clipping window bottom line, what is there, below that, if anything is there, that will be eliminated. So in this case, what we are going to do, the previous output what was there, that will be taken as the input for this particular step. And I am going to list all the edges from my previous output, which will be the input for this particular step now. So in the bottom clip, the two edges which are affected, they are the lines 4 to 5 and 5 to 6. So 4 to 5, if we consider, that is from inside to outside. When it is from inside to outside, so we are going to consider only one point, and that is nothing but the intersection point. So when we have the edge 5 to 6, this is nothing but outside to inside. When it is from outside to inside, we have to consider the intersection point and the inner point. So we have 56 and 6. So the output of 4 and 5 becomes only 45, whereas the line from 5 to 6 will be reduced to 56 and 6. So this is my bottom clip, this particular polygon. So this polygon will be the final output. The list of edges over here, it is nothing but the polygon what I am getting if I connect these points. So this is called as the polygon Hodgman. Sutherland-Hodgman polygon clipping algorithm. So we can clip the polygon by making use of this particular method. We have a examination question like this. You can solve this